Hey, this is Derek Hodge, and you're watching First Look.
Hello, I'm Don Was, the president of Blue Note Records. And today on First Look, we're going to be speaking with bassist, composer, arranger, record producer, Derek Hodge, about his latest release on the Blue Note label, an album called The Color of Noise. Hey, Derek, how you doing, man?
Don, I'm great, man.
Glad to hear it. Just to begin with, over the last couple of decades, you've built an incredible discography that I think everyone should know about. You've recorded and performed with a really wide array of artists, ranging from R&B legends like Q-Tip and Maxwell and Common and Jill Scott and Kanye West to jazz giants like Terrence Blanchard, Stefan Harris, Clark Terry, Mulgrew Miller. You produced Kendrick Scott, James Francis record. And I think one of the most significant adventures you've been on was as a founding member of the Robert Glasper Experiment, along with Chris Dave and Casey Benjamin. Let's talk about your new album, third one for Blue Note. Album's called The Color of Noise, which is also the name of the band. That's right. And the name of a song on the album. So let's get the big picture. What should people know about The Color of Noise?
It's an idea that was birthed way before I even wrote a single note for this album. It was all about a season of just acceptance, Don, you know, to be honest. After the second, my previous album, it just started to hit me that the love people over the last year started showing to that album and Live Today in particular. It's like anything that related to that, people seem to just start tagging me, redoing the music, showing, like, making it their own story. You know, mm-hmm. saying how it got them through their day, how it touched them, and they didn't know what place I was coming from when I wrote it, but that spoke to them, you know, in a very honest way. And I've just started paying attention to the universe. You know, I said, let me just follow that path. You know, I've been blessed, you know, to have this opportunity to record, and my relationship with you has just always been amazing and honest, and you've always, you know, left the door open. If there's anything honest and creative that comes to my mind, let's talk about it, let's speak, let's make it happen. And that is where the idea of Color of Noise, of acceptance, of taking all of that question mark of what the heck am I? And that was the spirit behind Color of Noise. You know, I'm really happy that it turned out the way it did.
Oh man, it's a beautiful record. One of the things that really impressed me in the studio was that you came in and really gave the musicians a tremendous amount of room to let go. You didn't play them the songs in advance. Some of them, I don't even know if you played on the bass in advance. Well, I think you
wrote played them. Yeah, absolutely not. And that was by design, you know. And honestly, a big credit to you is how that happened. You know, when you and I met, you honestly spoke to me in a way that was kind of reassurance. You said, hey, just trust it. Whatever happens, trust that moment that it's meant to be. I can't be saying I want that idea and speak that concept that you and I talked about, and then I show up just leaving no room for God to enter the room, you know, as Quincy Jones says. So I decided to honor that.
It comes through in the music, man. And it certainly was made the room magical while the session was going on, that's for sure. Let's talk about some of the songs. Tell me about Heartbeats.
Heartbeats was the first voice memo I created when I arrived back in my studio. The very first one. I don't think you even knew that.
I didn't know that. No.
Just literally looking at my family. I was watching them run back and forth in front of the piano, and I was looking at their photos in front of me. And it was just a certain emotion. There was no words. It was nothing overthought. I said, let me just document that feeling.
Very cool. Let's play some of that.
Cool.
Heartbeats from new album by Derek Hodge called The Color of Noise. Let's pick up another song. Let's play Color of Noise, in fact. Tell us about that one.
I wanted to get through a song or two where we finished and everybody was like, whoa, really? Just that take? And we're, I want them to feel, yes, this is about trust. Let's go. I feel Mike Mitchell, the true Mike Mitchell. I feel Mike Haberg. I feel Jahari Stampley. I feel Justin Tyson. I feel all the spirits and personalities. I even feel the album cover when I look at it. It just represents the story of the question mark of it all.
Let's play that one. Color of Noise from Derek Hodge's new record, The Color of Noise. Tell us about the song Not Right Now.
Man, Not Right Now was just one of those good feeling songs. Like, it is actually very specific voicings that's needed, where you have to turn off what we call jazz harmony and understanding, where you don't want to over embellish on the harmonies and make it lush. I wanted to sing in a really singer songwriter kind of way that felt like just, you know, history of American music type way. That ended up being the vibe just how I had hoped, just the guys taking it and running with it.
That's Not Right Now from Derek Hodge's new record, The Color of Noise. Let me ask you about one other song, which is the one that's not an original song, Fall. Tell us why you chose that and what it means to you.
Man, I'm glad you asked that, actually, man. Fall, this is new. I've never sat with one band in a room and we recorded an entire record, right, you know, within, you know, 2 days, and this is a new concept. Classic Blue Note, that process. And I'm so glad we documented that way. I had some amazing influences from Terrence Blanchard to Margaret Miller to, you know, a lot of other people. And, you know, one of the common denominators was Wayne Shorter was their hero. And it was by coincidence, that was the first jazz record I ever owned. And one of the first albums I learned when I got to college, it was Miles Davis, you know, Nefertiti. So Fall touched me in a certain type of way. Ron Carter spoke to me in a certain type of way. And maybe because me coming from a hip hop generation, before I even knew, Ron was one of the most sampled bases in hip hop history. Something about that spoke to me, you know? And when I fast forward to when I had the opportunity to meet Wayne Shorter, and it was on a Gretchen Parlato show, and he showed up with sheet music and had learned everything and had questions, asking when should he lay out. I was like, Wayne Shorter? He's showing us that respect and that love is, you know, and that spirit, man. I always said if I could, I wanted to take the time to give that love back to people like him whose shoulders we stand on. So that's why we did Fall, man. That was a one take thing. I hope he likes it.
I'm sure I love it, man. Let's play it. That's the Wayne Shorter composition, Fall, from a new album by Derek Hodge from Blue Note Records called The Color of Noise. All right, man. Well, it's a beautiful record. Congratulations to you. I think it's a work of art. It's going to be around for a very long time. People are going to be listening to this music and feeling it. And congratulations to you.
Thank you. Thank you for even Co-producing this album with me, man, it meant everything. So love to you, man.
It was an honor to be there, man. All right, well, thank you for joining us on First Look today. And we'll dig you later.
That's the album. Beautiful. Yeah.